Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches Director's Cut Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What are we doing up here in the painting room, which was locked and stuff? Well, I missed a few things, so I can soon get them. Well, look at them. Now, I didn't notice this. I went looking around these rooms because I had a feeling I missed something. This room and the adjoining one. So this is the ground floor. This one, I can't get a description of what floor it is, because it's always like that. But then, the last hallway. Oops. This is the third floor. Just curious if they call it the third floor. No. The last hallway. All the rooms on this floor. Yeah, they don't say. So maybe this is the, you know, because they call it the ground floor. I think that's a UK thing that's different from in the United States. We have ground floor, and then first floor, second floor, how they count it. As you say here, ground floor. Unfortunately, can't see anything. So that's my room. Strange African gallery, main bedroom. Oops, didn't mean to do that. I was trying to still look. The bathroom on the second floor. Well, here they call it the second floor. It's funny, it says first floor here, actually. But I missed something here. That was odd. I don't remember seeing that room. I had to find some way to get into that room. So that's interesting. There's another hidden room. Of course, like old Victorian houses. Plus, there's something else here. A key, right? Right, because we already have this, which is the... wait. Well, the blue key, which we used to get in here. Rusty golden key, I think that goes down to the basement. That's the key of the house itself. So then there's another key here. The silver key was rather generic looking. And this. I picked up the lid of the can as I thought it might come in handy. It was the lid of a can that I had picked up for some reason. Alright, so that's... I think that's it for this room. And then I was able to get the rope. Actually have a lot of items now. From over here, you can't grab it. Here you can. Strange. Got it. It was quite a strain carrying around the large length of rope. Yeah, plus everything else. Okay. So then up there, there's something to get. Which opens up possibilities. I was trying to grab the can. At this point, I wasn't going to bother with light switches anymore. Wait. Okay. So, there's this. A very dirty can. So we can't tell, I guess, what it is. Because it's dirty. So we go like this. A quick cleaning revealed it was a can of oil. Kerosene. There appeared to be oil in that can. What'd it say? Full... something full-bodied? Alright, so we've been needing oil for the lantern. Good idea, but how is I gonna get the oil from the can? Can we do it with this? Okay, we're not gonna oil the oil. Can we put it on the plate? Nope. We can't just open it? Why won't... We gotta make a hole in it? Is that a good idea? I stopped here, as you can tell, guys. This is all I saw. I managed to pierce a hole in the can. Well, we better hurry up and fill this. I poured some oil inside the lamp by tilting the can slightly. There was very little of it, though. There's now a small hole in the can. Can I put any more? There was no more oil left in the can. Oh my my. What's it say? The old-fashioned lamp made me think of exciting adventures I'd always dreamed of going on. Well, this is a horror adventure, so I'm not sure if you've dreamed about that. Well, then again, you are a horror writer, so it's possible. It's very possible. It's always more fun to write horror stories than to live them, I think. All right. So now we can go see what's in there, behind the elephant tusk, the room back there. Oh god, stop that. But yet, there's also this. There's something we couldn't see back here. I couldn't see clearly enough to identify the objects in that dark area. Now, I don't know how many times you can use this, so just in case, I'm going to save. Because I want to see what's behind the tusk cabinet more than what's in here. I mean, you'd think we could see both. I couldn't see clearly enough. I strained my eyes to detect if there was something useful among that junk. They give me something else there? No. Well, I thought we would light that area. Wait. There was enough light at the moment. There isn't enough light at the moment. Wait. Alright, never mind. I'm gonna actually restore my save because I'm worried that I wasted lamp oil. I don't know if it works like that, but just in case. So we also got another key. So that might go to outside. They might go to the chapel? Or the greenhouse. There's a greenhouse too. But he doesn't want to go outside at all because of the rain. So, we're not going to be doing that yet. And now that... I thought I heard a sound. Like a little tune. But, and now that we have a phone number for the bank, well, it's a Sunday. They're going to be closed anyway. But, the phone lines are down anyway, so... We're double foiled on that one. Now I'm really nervous to see what's behind the elephant tusk cabinet thing. Yeah. I mean, it's gotta be a good reason they barred that up. Well, actually... Whoa. This is where that room would be? Wait. So what we get there from... According to the blueprints I found, a door to the room, to a room, should be in this spot. Apparently there was a door in that part of the hallway. It's like wallpapered over or something. Is that wallpaper? That wasn't the best approach. Cut the wallpaper? Oh, I scratched at the wallpaper only to reveal a doorway that had been bricked up? I was very curious to learn what was on the other side of that door. I had to figure out some way of getting in. Now try the hammer? Wait, that's a key. That's not a hammer. You know what? Try it anyway. I would have spent ages trying to do that. Yeah, I don't know what else would help me get past that. So there's a doorway there, then what about from inside this room? I'm putting off looking in the tusk thing. Can I look behind this? Can I move that? Look at that, there's a gap like that. I don't know if that means anything, I don't know. That was a little pixel hunter-y too. Pixel hunter-y. Any clue in the paintings? You move a painting? Maybe we move this? Let's see if I can move this at all. No. So it would help me get past that, right? I don't have a good feeling about this. What was locked in here? The room was too dark. Did I use it on the room? Oh. An odd-looking African mask was positioned in the middle of the storeroom. Its presence made me feel terribly uneasy. Well, here I thought we were going to be attacked by something, so I'm a little relieved. We got notes. The corner was too dark to investigate. There was enough light at the moment. What? Oh, I hate you. Too dark, but there's enough light. Now that there was enough light, I extinguished the lamp to save the oil. Oh, okay. So now there's enough light. Wait, stop moving. Well, we got stuff to read. Cool. July 3rd. My recent researches on the Dalmor have shed some light upon their terrible activities. I understand now that the lack of existing information about them was not only a cause of their small size and rarity, but also a reluctance or rather superstitious attitude towards their nature. Pardon me. Even some of the most important historians of South Africa will refuse to mention their name, usually referring to them as the War Tribe. After digging in some of the most obscure books I could find about the subject, I must admit now that reading them made me very nervous and uneasy, bringing back the memory of those horrible acts I witnessed on the day. I can't understand why any human being, uncivilized or not, would behave in such a manner. War among savage tribes is, of course, very common and a recurring theme in history, but the Dalmor, they went even beyond war. Usually a tribe will engage in battle to conquer new territory or perhaps defeat an enemy. They did it for the sole reason of destruction and extreme love for violence. The account of their actions is downright scary. They'd invade villages, slaughtering every inhabitant without regard for their sex or age. Men, women, children would inevitably perish by their fury and hate, which is, I think, the most unsettling element of their stories. They didn't use any weapons. They killed villagers with their bare hands and teeth as if they were drawing power from an unearthly source. I find it hard to believe this, and if I hadn't seen them with my own eyes, I'd say there was some kind of wild legend. Once they'd slaughtered every living thing in the village, they'd burn it to the ground. Every single construction or possession of the fallen villagers, proof that they definitely were not interested in conquering or even taking some advantage of the terrain. Their motives were moved solely and purely by an incredible despisal of life and hatred towards anything that wasn't from their village. That is another curious thing. They somehow managed to sustain a constant population level as if they controlled exactly the amount of people needed for an attack, but at the same time warrant survival using their few existing resources. I fear this wasn't some kind of wondrous organization system, but rather an elimination process of a useless member or an unnecessary child. I dare not think about it, but I'm afraid this would explain why they didn't need to hunt for food. They feasted upon themselves. Now I know what the mask I took stands for, and I shiver at the thought of it. I must confess I'm worried. I don't know why, but I fear for my life. June 24th, 1962. Not long before he killed his wife, right? 63, he did. That's another date, though. Maybe I can read those papers upstairs. Dear Christopher, please excuse the tone of this letter. I know I must sound like a raving madman, but I truly can't find a proper way to put together all the thoughts that have been taking my sleep away these past days. There is a reason behind all those recent adversities. It's the mask. Christopher, it's that mask I told you about. I wouldn't believe it myself if I hadn't studied its origins on my own, but it's really the source of all my suffering. The tribe it belonged to, I must confess I didn't take the mask by, quote-unquote, appropriate means, and I fear this might have unleashed some terrible wrath against my life and everything that surrounds me. I think it's a bad idea locking the mask up. Just drive away from the house and leave the mask as far away as possible. It's been over a year ago since I witnessed the most outrageous acts of violence that not even in my worst nightmares could I have imagined, and the mask was the epicenter of it all. What I was thinking of when I took it is beyond me. It was probably a vicious streak of greed, but I can see clearly now. It represents evil, and I'm truly convinced this evil can somehow take shape and punish those who have disgraced it. I did, and now I must face the consequences. I will take some more time to investigate this. I might even go back to South Africa to seek help, although something tells me not even returning the mask would do any good. Yeah, there's that. The damage is already done, and I believe it's getting worse as the days go by. Every time I walk past the gallery, I can hear some incessant odd chatter, as if something was being plotted inside. And those voices, Christopher, they seem to be angry. Please help me. Come and see me as soon as you can. James. Wow. Okay. Oh, I thought the mask was gone. So we can't look at anything in these crates. Nothing else to look at, huh? Oops. Just taking note. Oh, that's the staircase. Going up. Right, right, right. So we're underneath the stairs. Alright. I don't know what I was expecting to find back there, but at least it wasn't as bad as I thought. What did I not read? Exhibitor. It looks like there is a hidden room on the second level of the house, unless the blueprints are wrong. I can't imagine any reason for it, but it's really there. The hidden room does exist, but I won't be able to get inside through the door. It's been completely bricked off. I have to find another way. The hidden door in the gallery led to a small storeroom. There was a strange mask inside and more memories belonging to James Blackwood. The developments of his story is finally getting into me now. I can almost feel his suffering, and that mask seems to be the key to the mystery. Indeed. Very much indeed. So, we couldn't get in that way. We couldn't get in the door. We couldn't get in... through that room. That's as far as I can do. The mirror! The mirror. Try the mirror. I knew there's a reason for this mirror that you can move. It's gotta be. Well, it's facing that way now. This shows us where the safe is. Does it? Wait. What am I looking at in this mirror? Can't stop. It's her. It's her in the painting, holding the thing. Oh, she looks different! Here she's wearing... red. So... what is that reflecting? It's reflecting this. Not this, but this. I'm trying to, like, pixel hunt my way around this thing. No luck here. Let me take a look from here. So here we can see in red. Still wonder if something's under the bed. Alright, so if we move the mirror, is that a key to this? I wish I could just click to one spot in the room and go directly there. Okay, so now I've moved that. It's reflecting something else. It's reflecting... this? don't know if that means anything. I still wish we could move this thing. It seems like a no-brainer. Something's behind it. It's easy to move that. Let's see if it'll let me. I mean, maybe not, because you can see most of the wall behind there. Hmm. Alright. I don't know. I mean, I can't go... he won't go outside. Because it's raining. Otherwise, I go look for some kind of boarded up window as well. But... there's more hallway. Maybe there's another door that we can get through from the other side. Because there's this. Hmm. Doesn't it seem like something else boarded up, right? Kind of featureless wall. Now the other option, if I go through the floor above, I think you use the blueprint to determine what's directly above that floor. I don't think I should be able to figure it out without doing that. Well, it doesn't go that far, does it? Let's look at the blueprints then. Because we have rope, so if we find a way, we can drop down. So, here's the special room. Given that the doorway had been bricked up, I wondered if one of the windows in the tower was close enough. Oh! We'll climb down from there? The tower's not even listed. Included here. Well, let's try attaching our rope to places up there, I guess. Hopefully we won't fall and break our neck. Right. Oh, the tower. That's the attic. Yeah, we want the towers this way. Okay, so we're here. It would have been too dangerous to tie the rope to the window. Can't tie it to this. Maybe we need to try the other window, because I know you can open two of them. That's gonna be too dangerous here as well. Oh, we won't even try it. tie it to this, maybe? It was too risky. The rusty metal frame would have torn the rope if I threw it out of the window. Same? I guess the same thing here. Oh! That one won't tear? It's the same as the other one. Alright, I guess I have to grab the rope. Oh. I'm not gonna go through a crack in the... Well... Maybe we will. The wall was already broken. The wall had a wider crack now. Well, yeah, already broken, but I can't get through there. I put it through the crack. The rope was hanging from the hole in the wall. Is it, does that go outside then? Do I? Okay, let me try the other. Because where do we pick up the rope? That's too far. Right, so where'd the rope go? It's hanging through a crack in the wall. So, I'm gonna stop for now. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.